Good evening. Tonight we're carrying on with the theme of people who sought and met Jesus and whose lives were changed by Jesus. Could I remind you again that the stories being shared are all true stories, and the majority of which are recorded in more than one of the Gospels. That's Matthew, Mark, Luke and John are the four Gospels of the Bible. We believe the Bible is written and inspired by God. The Bible says it is God-breathed. Nothing in the Bible has ever been proven inaccurate. Right from creation, to the flood, to the birth of Jesus, to his death, and to his resurrection. None has been disproven. That's incredible. People, of course, have tried to disprove the Bible over hundreds and hundreds of years, but they have all failed in their quest. Each night we have looked at how different people in the Bible sought Jesus. The first night we looked at Jesus saving a rich man whose name was Zacchaeus. Then we looked at the criminal on the cross hanging beside Jesus. We then looked at the leper. We then looked at how Jesus saved the blind man Bartimaeus. We looked at then Jesus saving the man possessed with the demons. And tonight, we are going to look at how Jesus saved a paralyzed man. Just to summarize the story, and then again, we look through the verses. This story can be found in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke. And tonight, we are going to look at the version recorded in Luke's Gospel, chapter 5, verse 17 to 26. Jesus had just entered a village called Capernaum. This village was situated on the north side of the Sea of Galilee in Israel. It would have been a fishing village. And as far as I know, you can still visit that village to this day. There was a paralyzed man in that village with no hope and possibly little joy in his life. The Bible tells us that his four friends carried him on a stretcher to see Jesus. There was a problem, though. They couldn't get him in to see Jesus because of the crowd. What they did to get him to the feet of Jesus, it was something you would not expect. But listen while we go through the story and you'll see how these men got this man, the paralyzed man, to the feet of Jesus. So let's look again. I have summarized in a few P's so you can keep your eye out for them. Verse 17. Firstly, and to no surprise, Jesus was passing by. That's my first P again. Jesus was passing by. As I've said on a few nights, I feel the Lord, through his Holy Spirit, is thriving with people in these days. COVID-19 has made a lot of people think about spiritual things. If you're thinking on spiritual things, if you think there's something missing in your life, then we believe that through the Holy Spirit, Jesus is challenging you currently. Deep down, I think you know it, and you know you're not right before God. If you know that, then keep pursuing Jesus while he is passing by at this time. The end of verse 17 says the power of the Lord was present. That's my second P. The power of the Lord was present. That is so important. Without the power of the Lord and through his Holy Spirit, you won't get saved. It's only through Jesus and through his Holy Spirit will you be saved. In Mark's version, in chapter 2, verse 2, it says, Jesus was preaching the word. That's my third P. That is what John and I are endeavoring to do each night at this mission, is to preach or speak God's word. Don't be offended at us and anything we say. We are only speaking from God's word. And it's God's word we want you to hear, not our words. Tonight I'm going to let you into a little secret. About 2 months ago, the Lord spoke to me very clearly from Ezekiel chapter 2 and 3. The Lord, through these two chapters, very clearly gave me a number of instructions. When he gave them instructions, the hairs were standing on the back of my neck, and I knew I had to obey his word. And the instructions, some of the instructions were this. He said, stand upon your feet, go and say unto them, thus saith the Lord, do not be afraid of the people. Speak God's words unto them. Speak my words unto them. Speak from the Bible. And finally, he said, warn the people. They were the instructions God gave me through Ezekiel chapter 2 and 3. And that is the reason why I'm doing this mission. And it's the reason why John is doing this mission as well. God also told me that there will be many rebellious people to God's word. But don't, Jonathan, don't get concerned about that. They're not being rebellious against you, but they're being rebellious to God. If that is you, please could I say, don't be rebellious to God and his message of salvation. There were other messages through these chapters in Ezekiel that God left with me over that week. I'll not take time to go into them all just now, but if you want to hear more about how God spoke to me through Ezekiel chapter 2 and 3, then please get in touch and I can share that with you. But let's get back to the text. Time's moving on. Verse 18, this is the fourth P. There was a paralyzed man who wanted to see Jesus. Verse 19, there was, of course, a problem. And we've seen in most of our stories how there was a problem. But the problem for the paralyzed man on this occasion was that there was a crowd. And obviously, he was paralyzed. He couldn't walk to see Jesus. However, this man had a great group of friends. Just look at what they'd done. They carried him to see Jesus. And when the house was crowded and they couldn't get in to see Jesus, they went up onto the housetop and cut a hole in the roof and lowered this man down into Jesus. The devil will put whatever obstacles he can in your way to prevent you coming to Jesus. You need to overcome that inward battle and pursue Jesus. Don't let the devil prevent you from coming to Jesus. Don't give the devil the victory. As I have said before, if you spell devil backwards, it says lived. If you can get rid of the devil in your life and get Jesus into your life, then you will have a life worth living. Verse 19, the next P, was the place. And I love this, and I've mentioned it. Look where his friends lowered him to. They lowered him into the midst of Jesus, right to Jesus' feet. All of you listening are sensible people. And a lot of you probably think the opposite of me. But you should know that the main purpose of this mission is to try and bring you into the midst of Jesus. We are trying to bring you to the feet of Jesus. Our aim is to present Jesus to you through his word, through the Bible, so you can live, so you can have eternal life, abundant life, and a guaranteed home in heaven. Without Jesus, you can't have any of them things. Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Verse 20 and 24 at the bottom of the slide, Jesus' power was displayed in two ways. Firstly, the man's sins were forgiven. His spiritual need was healed. Secondly, the man was healed of his physical need. What an amazing day this was for this man. Both his sins were forgiven and he was healed. In other words, he could rise and walk. I'm asking the question, how is it that Jesus has authority to forgive sins? Again, we've looked at this on a few of the nights. Well, Jesus, when he was being crucified, after he was beaten, scourged, the Bible says that God laid our sin upon him. God punished Jesus for our sin. That is why he is the only one who can forgive us of our sin. There's a couple of lovely verses in Isaiah chapter 53, verses 5 and 6. They're on the slide, and this is what they say. It says, but he, that's Jesus, was wounded for our transgressions, that's our wrongdoings. He was bruised for our iniquities, that's our sins. The chastisement or the punishment of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. With his stripes I am healed this evening. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid, as Jesus, laid on him, Jesus, the iniquity or the sin of us all. Verse 25 then. The man's response was that he immediately rose and glorified God. Now this is important. If you put your trust in Jesus Christ, you will automatically want to glorify him. You will want to publish, or you should want to publish it. And the conclusion of 3 points in the conclusion as we come to an end. And I'd like to just conclude, and my first point is a point to the Christians or to the believers that are listening. And the challenge is this: you need to do what it takes to get people into the midst of Jesus. Verse 20 said, when Jesus saw their faith, he said unto him, man, thy sins are forgiven thee. It was by this man's faith, by this man's friend's faith, that Jesus said unto the man, thy sins are forgiven thee. If you can get people into the midst of Jesus through the Holy Spirit, then don't be surprised at what the Lord might do. It says, and when he saw their faith. Christians, you have a responsibility to get people into the midst of Jesus. For those who still don't have that close relationship with Jesus and don't have the surety that Jesus has forgiven you, I want to leave this with you. Jesus has the power to forgive sins. No one else has that power. No one else can make you fit for heaven. It is only through Jesus. Why? We've talked about it. Because Jesus has taken the punishment for your sins, for my sins. He has taken the punishment in our place. John 1, chapter 1, verse 7-9 says, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. Verse 9, if we confess our sin, he, that's Jesus, is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us, as clean us from all unrighteousness. Confess your sins to Jesus. Trust him. Get up and walk for Jesus. Glorify him. If you get saved, you can't willingly continue in your own habits. You need to repent. In other words, you need to turn away from your sin and walk for Jesus. We looked at that with blind Bartimaeus, how he threw off his cloak, he threw off his past and followed Jesus. My third point then in conclusion is this. Your spiritual need is greater than your physical need. Jesus forgave this man's sins before he healed him physically. Your spiritual need is greater than your physical need. So, do you remember the 7 P's? I'll just finish with them. Jesus was passing by. The power of the Lord was present. The word was being preached. The paralyzed man had 3 problems. He had a spiritual problem, he had a physical problem, and he had to overcome the crowd or overcome the world, the obstacles which the devil puts in our way. 5th P was the place. Remember, he came into the midst of Jesus. Then 6th, Jesus displayed his power by forgiving him his sins. And then finally, the 7th P was he published it. Thank you for listening. I trust and pray that you come to Jesus seeking forgiveness of your sins. You repent and follow him. Again, if you have any questions or queries, then please do get in touch. Our contact details can be found on the website. And the website is www.gods-mission.com. Thank you so much for listening. And I trust and pray that you decide to follow Jesus. We just close in prayer. Thank you. Dear Lord and Heavenly Father, just pray tonight that through your word, you would speak to those listening. I pray, Lord, that all those listening who are not saved, Lord, who have not had their sins forgiven, that they will see their spiritual need and see, Lord, that you can forgive them, Lord, and that you can secure their place in heaven with you, Lord. Lord, we're thankful that you have the power to save. Lord, we're thankful that even to this day you're saving souls. Lord, again, we just pray and ask that you would continue to speak. You would continue to strive, continue to pass through, Lord. And may, Lord, through your Holy Spirit, people fall at your feet and give their lives over to you. Lord, thank you again. We pray, be with us, Lord. Amen. Thank you. Please join in to hear John tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Thank you.